Welcome to Seamedu News. Here are some stories. Seamless Education Academy awarded the Dajikaka Gadgil Scholarship to some of its outstanding students. Let's take a look at the wonderful event hosted by Seamedu.
The Dajikaka Gadgil Scholarship function was a prestigious event at Seamedu. Shri Dajikaka Gadgil gave scholarships to the deserving students selected by the formal process. Among the 8 scholarship recipients were Dipti Edul, Jinu Varghese, Aditya Naik, Sunita Bade, Apeksha Shirsagar, Rajdeep Paul, Aditya Virmani, and Sharvari Kulkarni. It concluded with the students being appraised for their hard work. The event was motivating enough when Daji Kaka himself stood to speak a few words.
Aaj apan sarvani ye bakshise milele tyabaddal tumja tuma sarva mulanche mi team education tarfe abhinandan karto.
Mr. Shiva Gupta, MDC Medio, and all the HODs were present to grace the occasion.
Global celebrations were made to celebrate Charles Dickens' 200th birth anniversary. Let's see how Dickens' biggest fans, the royal couple of UK, remembered him on this historical day.
200 years ago was born one of the greatest writers in the English language, Charles Dickens. He was considered the greatest English novelist of the Victorian period. Dickens remained popular than any other previous author, having been responsible for some of English literature's most iconic novels and characters. Dickens's work has been highly praised for its realism, comedy, mastery of prose, unique personalities, and concern for social reform.
It's from childhood that I've been through his books like Oliver Twist, David Copperfield, A Tale of Two Cities. In all through these classics, I've understood that Charles Dickens not only incorporated a kind of contemporariness in his stories, but also reserved a very deep understanding between his characters and us. Therefore, I've felt a deep connection between his stories and me. It's evident that every student should have been going through his books, have learned a lot.
The 200th anniversary of the birth of Charles Dickens was celebrated in the Museum of London, who hosts the UK's first major exhibition on the author. The Prince of Wales and the Duchess of Cornwall have led global celebrations marking the anniversary. Prince Charles laid a wreath at the author's grave in Poets' Corner as part of a service at Westminster Abbey. The royal couple also visited the Charles Dickens Museum in London. Celebrations in Portsmouth began earlier in the day at a ceremony outside the writer's birthplace, where his great-great-grandson, Ian Dickens, laid a wreath. Thousands of Dickens fans flocked in to visit his house and also observe the preserves in the museum.
The 54th annual Grammy Awards were held at the Staples Center in Los Angeles this year. It was a musical night and delightful treat for all the audiences across the world.
Hosted by LL Cool J, the Grammy Awards organized on 12 February 2012 were a huge celebration of the music fraternity. A total of 78 awards were presented. The award show began with a Bruce Springsteen performance, followed by an LL Cool J prayer for Whitney Houston. A tribute for her was performed by Jennifer Hudson. Adele won all of her 6 nominations, tying Beyoncé's record for most wins by a female artist in one night. Adele's album 21 was the album of the year, while Rolling in Deep from the same album won the Record of the Year and Song of the Year awards. Bon Iver received the Best New Artist award. Foo Fighters and Kanye West followed with 5 and 4 awards respectively. Foo Fighters walked away with all the awards in the rock category. Kanye West, on the other hand, featured in the list of awardees in every single one of the rap section. Stage-shattering performances by Bruno Mars, Katy Perry, Nicki Minaj, Chris Brown, David Guetta, and Adele were the highlights of the show. The 54th Grammys were the second highest rated in its history with 39.9 million viewers. The rating was 50% higher than last year.
Some more news after the break.
We'll be right back.
Pune witnessed the 38th Firodiya Karandak this month. Large crowd of students and theatre enthusiasts flocked in to see the finals at Yashwant Rao Theatre.
The four decades old drama competition still relevant to its promises that have been to provide quality platform to the youngsters of Pune. The 38th Firodiya Karandak, an inter-college play competition, kicked off on 13th February at Ganesh Kala Krida Manch. This year, the competition witnessed performances coming from 24 different colleges. Great artists like Nitin Tadunge, Deepak Rege, Chinmay Kirkar and Kedar Paranspe were jury for the primary round. 9 colleges were selected for the final fight, includes the BMCC, COEP, VIT, VIIT, Navale College, MIT COE, PICT, DES Law and ILS Law College. The roars of Karandak Konacha, followed by slogans of cheering various colleges, filled the air at the Yashwant Rao Theatre Auditorium, which was the venue of the Firodiya Karandak Finals. After amazing performances by 9 finalist colleges, the winners were announced late on Tuesday evening. Chiyutai, the play performed by MIT College, backed the COEP Karandak 2012, and VIT College and COEP College got the second and third prizes respectively.
The atmosphere here is so energetic, it's exciting to see the increasing involvement and how people are eagerly waiting to see their further performances. I have some participants with me right now. Let's see what they have to say.
Hello, myself Gaurav Moghe. I'm from College of Engineering, Pune. We have done a play named Don Cutting this year. I have done Firodiya for the last years. It's a very awesome experience. We grow as a human being also very good. I learned to play drums in this thing, and it's actually a very team event, so we grow as a team and also the leadership qualities also increase. Okay, thank you, that's it.
Hi, my name is Gaurav Tatwavadi. I'm from COEP. I'm the cultural secretary for the college. On the present on-team team, I was doing lights. I learned a lot of technical things, and it was a great experience for doing this Firodiya. This time Firodiya was having a lot of creative experiences, a lot of new events, so it was just an awesome experience. That's it, thank you.
That's all for now. With cameraman Aditya Naik, this is Sonal Bum from Seamedu News.
Moving on to our next segment. China looked beautifully lit up this month as its citizens celebrated the Lantern Festival. It marked the end of the first month of their new year.
The Lantern Festival is a traditional Chinese festival since Han Dynasty more than 2000 years ago. It is celebrated on the 15th of the first month in the lunisolar year in the Chinese calendar, the last day of the lunisolar Chinese New Year celebration. This year, the Lantern Festival was held in Lugang, Changgao County on 6th February. The event entered its 23rd year. It opened with performances by well-known local and international performance groups. People went out at night to various temples carrying paper lanterns and solving riddles on the lanterns. In modern times, lanterns have been embellished with many complex designs. Lanterns are now often made in shapes of animals also. Each year, the festival features a main theme lantern based on the Chinese zodiac animal for the New Year. This is complemented by secondary lantern and areas highlighting different decorative lantern themes, such as the blessing lantern area and joyous lantern area. Lantern Festival, held annually by the Tourism Bureau, has become the most highlighted event in China celebrated during the Lunar New Year holiday.
Sustainable lifestyle for all was the theme of the 6th Kirloskar Vasundhara International Film Festival. It was an innovative attempt to explore nature and its various elements.
The 6th Kirloskar Vasundhara International Film Festival was held this month at the Balgandharva Rangamandir and Ishanya Mall in Pune. Veteran stage and film actor Vijay Mehta inaugurated the festival. It screened acclaimed films from across 25 countries. Apart from this, the festival also featured a photo exhibition, nature walks, workshops, green conferences, cultural programs, quiz competitions, open forums and audio-video presentations, which were aimed at exploring issues related to environment, wildlife, energy, air and water. The prestigious Vasundhara Awards were conferred upon filmmaker Krishendu Bose activist Babulal Gandhi, city-based organization Aarti, and green teacher Irak Barucha. This was followed by a special audiovisual show by environmental activist and writer Bittu Sehgal on communicating climate change and conversation through films. The festival was a great platform for filmmakers to portray the message of environment conservation and also to show their love for the same.
Smartphones have been amazing pieces of technology in the field of business and social activities. Their powerful impact has led to many new inventions in this area.
A smartphone is a mobile phone built on a mobile computing platform with more advanced computing ability and connectivity than a feature phone. Modern smartphones typically also include high-resolution touchscreens, web browsers that can access and properly display standard web pages, and high-speed data via Wi-Fi and broadband. In comparison, feature phones more commonly run on proprietary firmware with third-party software support through platforms such as Java ME or Brew. The most common mobile operating systems used by modern smartphones include Apple's iOS, Google's Android, Microsoft's Windows Phone, Nokia's Symbian, RM's BlackBerry operating system, and embedded Linux distributions such as Memo and Migo. The latest most popular smartphones includes Nokia's Lumia, Samsung Galaxy series, and Apple's iPhone. Also with development of smartphones, the worldwide mobile phone subscriptions grew from 12.4 million to over 5.6 billion.
Thank you for joining us in this news bulletin. See you in the next bulletin. Goodbye.